How do you feel after getting success in IAS exam 2012?
When I got the news of my result in the Civil Service 2012 examination, the first reaction was of extreme relief and elation. And I think this is a huge opportunity that has been given to me. And I wish to make the best use of it by giving back to society and by being able to serve people at the grassroots level and in diverse areas of administration. So I think I would take it as an opportunity and as a challenge in the coming years to come.
What's your aim in life?
Well, my whole motivation to prepare for civil services and sit for the exam was that I wanted to choose a career that would help me to contribute maximum and touch people's lives somewhere right at the grassroots, to understand India's problems and be a part of the solutions. And I think it's very easy for all of us to be bystanders and point out that this is going wrong or that is going wrong, but to see any change that we wish it to see, I think it's very important to be part of it, of the change. And I think as our society is progressing towards higher levels of economic and human development, I think I wish to be part of that change. I wish to be able to facilitate the development of our society and contribute in society building in India. And I wish to be able to contribute fruitfully in policy making, etc., at the higher levels of administration. And I think civil services, specifically IAS, gives you an opportunity to serve at every area of governance, because it's a very holistic kind of service. You get to touch maximum lives, and you get to bring about substantial changes, and you get that position where you can bring about various positive developments, upliftment of disadvantaged groups, tribal empowerment, women empowerment, safety and security of women and children in our country are some of the areas that I would really wish to contribute in. So that is my aim in life.
Tell us about your educational background, schooling and higher education.
I did my schooling from Delhi Public School, Noida. I took science with economics, PCM with economics in 11th and 12th. And thereafter, I went on to do my graduation. I did my economics honours from Miranda House, University of Delhi. And right after my graduation, I started preparing for the civil service examination. My father is an engineer in NTPC Limited, Noida. And my mother is a homemaker. And I have an elder sister, Shubhashweta.
When did you choose to become a civil servant and why?
I think right since my schooling days, I wished to take up a career that would give me an opportunity to serve people in society right from the grassroots level, and also give me an opportunity to contribute in policy decisions and decision making at the higher levels in governance. So when I came to third year of my graduation, I decided that civil services would give me this opportunity, and I decided to start preparing for it right after my graduation rather than going for any other field at this point of time. This was my first attempt.
How much time one should give for the preparation of civil services exam?
Well, I feel 8 to 9 months of focused study is required before one gives an attempt in the civil services. And apart from that, the style of asking questions and the examination pattern has becoming more dynamic. So I think it's an ongoing process right from school to college. I think every experience is a learning experience which contributes ultimately when you write answers in the exam and you face questions in the interview board. So I think it's a cumulative process, but I think focused preparation of 8 to 9 months is required.
Who is your role model? What are your hobbies and interests?
My father is my role model first of all, and right since childhood I have learnt that whatever one should do with honest intentions and with his or her 100%. So I've imbibed, I've tried to imbibe as much of his guidance as I could. And this whole interest and this whole wish to contribute towards society and be of help to people and try to solve their problems and bring about positive change in the society has been inspired by him. So I consider him as my foremost role model. And apart from that, from time to time, there have been various people in public life who've been role models, and it's a continuous process. I think we take inspiration from each and every person who contributes and does commendable deeds in society. So I think it's a learning experience for all of us continuously.
Did you use internet? How helpful was it?
Yes, internet was a very big help and a great source of knowledge during my preparation, because I was not venturing outside my home too much to gather information from coaching institutes, etc. And internet helped me to keep updated with current affairs, various websites, ministry websites, planning commission website. These really helped me to kind of keep pace with the dynamic and changing nature of current affairs and other aspects in the general studies, as well as my optional papers. And it's becoming almost indispensable in any kind of preparation for this examination these days.
What do you think about JagranJosh.com?
I think Jagran Josh, as I came to know, is a website giving keeps updating current affairs information and keeps one abreast with all the competitive examinations. I think that's a very commendable effort, and it's really required for providing information and awareness to candidates all across the country, even to far off places where a lot of magazines and newspapers might not reach. So I think through the internet, this is a very good medium to kind of connect candidates all across the country. So I think it's a very commendable effort.